Hello, I'm Marlene Drinkwine, and this is the new auditorium at Long Beach City College. It is my distinct pleasure to welcome you to our virtual ribbon cutting ceremony today, officially marking the completion of the Building J, also known as our auditorium renovation. Long Beach City College is so excited to finally celebrate this incredible improvement to a much beloved building. And we are thrilled that you are able to join us today to catch a glimpse of these exciting changes. I would like to introduce the members of our Board of Trustees, President Vivian Malaulu, Vice President Uduak Joe Intook, Trustee Dr. Virginia Baxter, Trustee Doug Otto, Trustee Sunny Zia. Next, I would like to recognize the Citizens Oversight Committee for their oversight of our bond program. Eric Berg, Eric David, Sharon Diggs Jackson, Joan Greenwood, Aaron Moore, Summer Temple, Dr. Rebecca Turrentine, and ASB President Cesar Fierro Arizon. Let's start at the beginning for this unique and impressive building to show you how Long Beach City College strives to preserve historical aspects while providing our students with the most modern of technologies available. This building is the perfect example of both. Here to share the history of the auditorium is someone who spent a lot of time on the former LBCC auditorium stage. Dr. Gary Thomas Scott is the retired Dean of Creative Arts and Applied Sciences and a San Gabriel School District Board member. Please welcome Dr. Scott.
I am so honored to be sitting in what I consider to be a beloved space in Long Beach, not only for Long Beach City College, but for the whole community. This auditorium was originally built and dedicated in May of 1957. In the intervening 60 plus years, there have been so many concerts and events by significant people that have been not only a beneficiary for this college, but for the whole community. Dr. George Shaw, who was our director of jazz studies for so many years, created a jazz artist concert series that included over 35 just absolutely amazing jazz musicians. From Cab Calloway to Jeff Clayton to Wilton Felder, Don Ellis, Dizzy Gillespie, Lionel Hampton, Joe Pass, Patrice Rushen. That's just a sampling of all of the professional musicians that have performed on this stage. This auditorium housed Spring Sing for over 50 years, which gave students at Long Beach City College the chance to perform and to gather and celebrate who they were as a college community. This has been the place for the gatherings for faculty and for other major events here at the college. But this room has been a gathering place for so many events, not just for Long Beach City College, but for the Long Beach community. So many events for our students to have a premier world-class space to demonstrate their learning and knowledge that they had gained in their studies here at the college. We were also honored to have during this time two performances of the Los Angeles Philharmonic Orchestra. And at the second one, Esa-Pekka Salonen, who was the conductor of the orchestra at the time, stopped about 30 seconds into the first piece and said, "The acoustics in this room are so great. This is so much better than what we have at the Dorothy Chandler Pavilion." And everybody nodded, but this has been and continues to be a world-class venue for acoustics, as well as all of the visual and performing events that we've done here. It's hosted our theater productions, dance productions, and it will continue to be that kind of a resource as we go ahead, and we hope for the next 60 years. Long Beach City College, congratulations on your commitment to keep this space such a vital and important part of this college and this community.
Hi, I'm Dr. Mortensen, Professor of Theater Arts, Long Beach City College. I'd like to thank you all who are responsible for the auditorium, Board of Trustees, thank you. And in the time-honored tradition of theater, I'd like to do an audition for the next production. I'm gonna start with Shakespeare's Hamlet, and then I will segue into Streetcar Named Desire as Blanche DuBois.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Now it is my privilege to introduce our board president, Vivian Malaulu. She is the first Latina elected to the board to represent Area 2, which covers all of West Long Beach and the South Central parts of Long Beach. She has collaborated with our current theater faculty on projects since joining the board, so we know how excited she is for the completion of this building. Please join me in welcoming Board President Malaulu.
On behalf of the entire Board of Trustees, I welcome you virtually to the Long Beach City College Liberal Arts Campus. Today, we celebrate the renovation of Building J, the Auditorium, the epicenter of the great performing arts that exist at LBCC. I would like to thank our local voters and taxpayers for their strong support of Long Beach City College. Voters approved 3 local bond measures allowing us to make significant modernizations to the college. This is a strong testament to the partnership this college has with the community as a whole. LBCC has been the catalyst for success in many students over many generations. With these renovated facilities, we are setting the stage, literally and figuratively, for the success of future generations of artists. I know that this was not how we all envisioned opening up the auditorium when we held our groundbreaking ceremony a few years ago. But I can tell you that this building is worth the wait. We are all looking forward to that day when we all come back to the campus to enjoy the variety of entertainment that takes place in this venue. Singing, dancing, musical performances, and theatrical productions, all by LBCC students. I guarantee that you'll be blown away with the talent that is demonstrated here on a regular basis. On behalf of the board, I'd like to thank our interim superintendent president, Luann Bynum, vice president, Marlene Drinkwine, the performing arts faculty and staff, the facilities team, and everyone at Cordova Corporation for their management of the bond projects. And thanks to all of you for joining us to celebrate this important milestone for Long Beach City College.
Luann Bynum is a familiar face to many before the Board of Trustees appointed her as our interim superintendent president. She spent 20 years working at LBCC before she retired in 2017 as the executive vice president. She came back in March to serve the students of LBCC. Please welcome interim superintendent president Luann Bynum.
Thank you, Vice President Drinkwine, and thanks to each of you for joining us today. As the interim superintendent president, it's my genuine pleasure to share with our wonderful community this beautiful auditorium. As you may know, I was an administrator here for 20 years before I retired in 2017. I left just a few months before the auditorium was closed for what we will consider one of the best costume and set changes you will ever see. I spent many hours in the old auditorium for college gatherings, music, and theatrical performances. I would sit in the audience and wish they would turn on the air conditioning. Then I would remember, oh yeah, there is no air conditioning. Those days are over. Long Beach City College is now home to a modernized, sleek building that really is the premier performing arts venue in the region. It's going to be an amazing learning space for both our faculty and students. With the completion of this renovation, it gives us hope during these challenging times to think of the amazing performances that will take place here in the future. I want to give my genuine thanks to the community for supporting LBCC by approving the Measure LB and Measure E bonds that have allowed for this huge undertaking to become a reality. It is my sincere hope that very soon we will enjoy this amazing facility in person. as will the neighbors and children of this very deserving community. I'm looking forward to the day when we can all return to campus and throw a celebration in this incredibly remodeled auditorium. Thank you again for tuning in today, and congratulations to our wonderful contractors, our bond team, our facilities crew, the user groups that worked on this, and everyone else involved in this project. So break a leg, Vikings!
Our next speaker was named Dean of Social Sciences and Arts in 2017, just as the auditorium was closing shop for the remodel. Since then, she has been supporting her team throughout this adventure of packing, moving, construction decisions, swing spaces, and the move-in. Her roots run deep on campus as the daughter of a faculty member, an alumna, and as a member of the history faculty herself since 1999. Please welcome Dean Lisa Orr.
Since this auditorium opened in 1957, the talent gracing its stage has truly made this facility a hallmark for the community to gather for quality performances and education. Singers, dancers, actors, lecturers, professionals, and students alike have experienced the thrill of what it can be like to stand on the stage in front of nearly 1,000 people. Our Juilliard-educated industry professional faculty members are excited to share their own talents in educating students utilizing improvements inside these walls, featuring a much-needed audio-visual system, a new dance studio equipped with full-height mirrors, ballet bars, and sprung floor, an updated costume shop, a new star dressing room for featured performers and conductors, massive upgrades to the theater production workshop area, and a new modernized lobby with digital signage, concierge, and ticket area. It's just, I think, going to be something that instructors are going to love teaching in and that students are going to find just an absolute joy to be in and to learn and grow in their area of expertise. So I'm really, really thrilled about that. In terms of thinking about how maybe the rest of us will feel in coming to these new facilities, it's going to be a beautiful place to view the performances. I mean, I'm not myself a dancer or an actor or anything like that, but I know that I can't wait to see, you know, a music performance here or a play or a dance concert. I also know that there's nothing like this at any of the colleges close by. So we're really in a very unique and privileged position to have facilities like this. On behalf of the theater, dance, and music faculty and staff in the Performing Arts Department, we look forward to seeing you all when the first curtain rises again.
I hope you now understand the phenomenal levels of excitement we are feeling now that the auditorium renovations are complete. Can you blame us for being excited to welcome all of you back just as soon as we are able? We are looking forward to the day when these new auditorium chairs will be filled with our students, faculty, staff, and community members. We can't wait to have our stage showcase all of the talent we have here at Long Beach City College. I would also like to thank those who played very vital roles in bringing this project to fruition.
Thank you to CVA architects Bob Simons and Carlos Perez,
our general contractor Novus Construction, Jason Hama, Alan Strauss, Rafael Luna, Josh Hertan, and Carlo De Jesus. Thank you to the members of the bond management team, Cordoba Corporation's George Fa, John Duong, Trevor Mason, Russell Jones, David Navarro, Molly Grisette, and Nicole Soria-Villarde and team. To the user groups, you have all played an important role in shaping the design of this renovation. Dean Lisa Orr, the department heads, faculty, and staff. A big shout out to Auditorium Technical Coordinator Nate Stuffel for all of his input and talent as well. And of course, the team from Administrative and Business Services, including Project Manager of Education and Multimedia Technologies, Myra Aguilar and her team, Director of Business Support Services, Bob Raposa and his team, and Senior Director of Facilities, Construction and Operations, Walter Johnson and his team. You all kept this massive project moving along, and I am grateful. Thanks to all of you for being online with us today. Now let's get that ribbon cut. On with the show.
Yeah!